नमस्ते बच्चों, खुश रहिए आप लोग। मैं सर डॉक्टर शिल्पाश्री शाह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। आई एम फ्रॉम फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स। सो टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द बर्न, ओके, बर्न एंड इट्स मैनेजमेंट। सो व्हाट इज बर्न? बर्न इज एन एक्सटर्नल इंजरी कंप्राइजेस डैमेज टू द स्किन। इट कैन बी ड्यू टू एनी कॉज, ओके, एंड देयर कैन बी लॉस ऑफ स्किन एंड अंडरलाइंग टिश्यूज ऑफ द स्किन एंड इम्पेयरमेंट ऑफ फंक्शन ऑफ इट। ओके, सो देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ बर्न एज वी यू नो, थर्मल बर्न, ओके, फ्लेम बर्न एक्सेट्रा आर अवेलेबल। सो वट हाउ द थर्मल बर्न इज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, ओके, वट आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ थर्मल बर्न? वुंड हैव इरेगुलर बॉर्डर एंड डेप्थ ऑफ इंजुरी वेरीज, देन एक्सपोज सर्फेस ऑफ बर्न यूनिफॉर्मली, देन usually results in partial thickness burn. Okay, then there is scalp burn, which can be due to contact without hot liquid, then chemical burn from acids or any strong alkali, okay, then electrical burn from electrical current. Okay, these are various types of burn. Then there is another thing, that is inhalation burn. What is inhalation burn? You know, thermal injury can cause sustained by inflammation, inhalation of flame. Like if you inhale any hot fumes or gases by any something or any accident, okay, what happens? This place is a major threat to upper respiratory tract, okay, so causing edema of the upper respiratory tract, that is larynx, pharynx or trachea. Then early diagnosis of the inhalation injury is very essential. The patient may intubate it before the edema becomes extensive, so it is very important to diagnose inhalation injury, as this will prevent the passing of endotracheal tube, because if the edema develops or it the consequence of it may go further, then the passing of endotracheal tube will be very difficult. Therefore, the early diagnosis is essential. Okay. So, as we know, there are various types of classification of burn, like superficial, first one, 1 degree burn, then 2 degree A, that is superficial partial thickness burn, then 2 degree B, that is deep partial thickness burn, then 3 degree deep or full thickness burn, then dermal burn or 4 degree burn. Okay, so what are the, how the burn will expose or mechanism of injury? Then first one is superficial burn. It may be due to sun exposure, hot liquid, okay, low viscosity hot liquid, short exposure, then layer of skin that is involved is epidermis, or the patient's skin will appear as pink, red, okay, moist or no, but no blister will form in first degree. Pain will be there, moderate to severe pain, okay, no scar will be available, but healing time is 3 to 7 days. Then is superficial partial thickness burn, in which mechanism of injury is hot liquid, chemical burn, etc. The layer of skin involved is superficial papillary dermis. Okay. Then blister will form, red, moist, intact epidermal appendages, blanched skin, okay, due to pressure. Then pain will be severe, minimal scar will be there, and 1 to 3 weeks to heal this burn. Then deep partial thickness burn or 2B, 2 degree B, where flame, electrical, hot liquid with high viscosity can be the mechanism of injury. Okay, then deeper layer, that is reticular dermis, will be involved. Dry, white, non-blanching, loss of all epidermal appendages in this case. Okay, pain will be minimal, as there is deeper be deeper, so pain will be minimized, as nerve endings get damaged, you can get damaged due to that, so minimal pain will be feel. High risk of scarring and contracture, and 3 to 6 weeks with scar develop. Okay, then 3 degree burn, flame, electrical, chemical blast or self immolation. Then layer of skin into full thickness of skin and into subcutaneous or deeper. Okay, when leathery, dry, white or red with thrombosed vessel. None of the zone of coagulation, but painful surrounding the tissue will happen. Severe risk of scarring and contracture. Deal not heal by primary intention or require skin grafting. But now the last one is 4 degree, in which black textured with stirred rice skin, and remember that in which the muscles, bones, everything will get damaged. Okay, risk of contracture will be high in this case. Okay. Now pathophysiology of burn. Remember, in depth of knowledge of pathophysiology of burn, there are three zones. First one is zone of coagulation, that is necrosis, in which the burn portion will not replace with the new tissue, or it will, the cell will get properly damaged. Okay, then outer layer is zone of stasis, that is damaged skin, in which it can be happen, there is a chance of growing new tissue. And then last, the outermost layer is zone of hyperemia, where, or survival zone, in which there is very much chances of growing of new tissue. Now, what are the changes what are the complications of the burn? First one, cardiovascular changes like myocardial depression, reduction of contractility of heart, okay, increased heart rate, fear, then edema formation will happen in the body part, okay, then hypovolemia, okay, then what are the other changes like respiratory changes, the patient will feel bronchoconstriction, okay, exacerbated inhalation injury, etc. Other than that, metabolic changes like loss of muscle mass, okay, lymph muscle mass or wasting, okay. Then increased body temperature, increased oxygen and glucose consumption, increased CO2 and minute ventilation, increased heart rate for up to 2 years or more post burn, okay. Then there will be edema, as I have already told you. Increased vascular permeability, which occurs during inflammatory response, exacerbate the edematic condition. Okay. These are all the consequences of this condition, which the patient will develop due to burn. Okay. Now you have already know about the rule of nine, right? What is that? In which the limb will, the part of limb will characterize as how much percentage of burn is involved. Like head and neck with 18%, then chest 18%, then upper limb it 9% and 9% for both hand. Then the lower limb is 18% in both sides. Then perineum is at 1%. This is the rule of 9 to distinguish the percentage of burn. Okay. So what is the survival rate? There is something, the survival rate. How we will define that? The survival rate, that is chance of the patient to recover or survive after burn. There is one rule like 100 minus patient's age plus percentage of burn. Okay, or percentage of TBSA, total body surface area. So suppose a patient is of 20 age and the percentage of burn TBSA is 70%, then how much percentage of survival rate? It is 100 minus 20 plus 70. So 20 plus 70 is 90. So there is rate of chance of surviving is 100 minus 90, that is 10% chance of burn. Okay. So if you ask them by any question or anyone, that what is the prognosis of burn or what is the percentage chance of survival of a burn patient, that you have to calculate like 100 minus patient's age plus TBSA. Okay. Or percentage of TBSA, total body surface area. Okay. So this is that. Then how we will manage the burn or patient with burn? First, we all know fluid, okay. First aid treatment and with fluid, okay. So flame burn must be smoothed, cold water applied continuously over the burned area, okay. Then medical management also involved the condition with water-based treatment, fluid to prevent dehydration, pain and anxiety medication, and topical ointment or dressing, etc. have to be given. Okay, so you have to describe all the conditions, then there are some surgical options available like grafting. Okay, so there are allograft, autograft, heterograft, etc. Grafting is changing of your involves in or induced skin with another sound skin or good skin. Okay, so autograft or allograft you can use, that is in Ohombo, that is taken the mammal skin of any cadaver. You can use any other animal skin or as a grafting also. Okay, so this is the grafting option available. Okay. So autograft, allograft, heterograft, cultured skin, artificial skin also available. Sheet graft are there, those which are not altered once they have been taken off from the donor side. Okay, there is mesh graft are those which are passed through the machine that places fenestration. That means the graft will pass through a machine and that will fenestrate for like growing of hair follicle. So they will fenestrate the place and small holes will be there in the graft. Okay, mesh grafts have advantage over a sheet graft. Okay, now the physiotherapeutic treatment also is there for the burn patient. How the we have to remember that we have to taken the patient for consideration of all cardiovascular plus pulmonary plus musculoskeletal plus neurological condition. As we know, the complication of infection, due to inflammatory condition, there will be infection or increased risk of mortality. Then pulmonary condition due to inhalation injury or carbon monoxide poisoning. Then metabolic loss. Okay, cardiac or circulatory disturbance, musculoskeletal, neurological disturbances happen as a complication. So we have to consider everything along with pain. So what are the goal of physiotherapy? They will prevent respiratory complication, prevent edema or control edema, prevent deformity, minimize burn scar, okay, prevent loss of strength, then promote physiological healing, then minimize hypertrophic ossification, investigate home condition, okay, home situation. Okay, so then with the considering this goal, the patient will have to be assess first, like patient's age or date of burn or date type of burn, then survival rate, okay, then past medical history, if there is any other burn condition, or if there the patient have diabetes mellitus or any type of disease that can cause the complication of this condition. Okay, so we have to know all about this. Then range of motion we have to check. Okay, note general measurement of the part that is involved with the burn. So we have to check that, then check the muscle strength. Okay, then we have to check the functional ability, gait of the patient, if the patient can walk properly, check the gait deviation, then assist if the patient can walk properly. Okay, we have to check all this, the neurological, if the patient's neurological disturbance is there, or you have to check the sensation or motor changes, like if the patient can move his or her limb properly. Okay, then respiratory changes you have to check. Okay, so after that we have to treat the patient accordingly. Okay, for infection control, strict hand washing before treatment you have to give. Okay, we have to use a strict hygiene. Okay, strict hygiene we have to take, and then exercise, like passive exercise if the patient is not able to move his or her affected limb or hand. Okay, then after that, positioning is very important to prevent contraction. If the patient with the different limb or different part of the body involved, we have to position the patient likewise. Like if the patients have anterior neck burn, then what will develop? The patient will have contracture, like, right? The patient will may develop contracture of any neck extension. So we have to take the patient in a position that the patient will not develop contracture. Okay, so then splinting, positioning, okay, these are the treatment option available. Then treatment of graft extremities, gait training also may be given. Then respiratory care is with shaking, clapping or postural drainage or cuffing techniques. Okay, if you very much uncomfortable for the patient to have hand pressure applied to chest part, then a piece of foam may be given to support that body part, okay, or chest. Okay, humidification may be necessary for non-ventilated patient. Okay, breathing exercise are very important in this condition, as the inhalation injury can hamper the upper respiratory tract and thereby the whole pulmonary system. After the joint range of motion, positioning, splinting exercise are used for maintaining and improving the condition. Okay, positioning, as I have already told you that how positioning can improve to prevent the joint contracture. Okay, suppose anterior neck is involved, the common contracture, as I told you, neck flexion, then we have to put the patient's head on extension or neck on extension like that. If the posterior neck is involved, then what will develop? The patient will develop neck extension contracture, right? So the patient's head should be in flexion position and sitting or lying with a pillow behind the neck like that. Okay, like that, with every part involved, we have to take the patient into consideration. We have to position him like him or her like that. Okay, this is all about today's class. This is all about burn patient, how we can manage the burn patient, how we can deal with the patient, what types of burns are available, are there, how the mechanism of injury, what are the mechanism of injury, how we can treat medically and surgically, and plus physiotherapeutic treatment. Okay, so this is all about today's class. If there is any question, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you. Khushriya.